I still got bruises, you know. Lucky I went easy on you. Okay, let's see. Now, where did you get this, I wonder? Okay. Very nice. Shame to part with it, I bet. All right. Come across a few of these myself. Got a few of those, huh?
Real good doing business with you.
Bye. Stay safe and quiet.
Look.
Whoa, whoa, steady there. I'll scare away my dinner. Yes, I know where you are. Got him! Did you see that? Perfect! You sure are a beauty. Well, best be on the way.
Well, shit, you're good at this.
Yep.
Okay, boy. Yeah. Whoa, easy. You're okay. You're all right. Don't worry. Okay. There. Done, boy. Yep. Easy.
Have to worry about supper tonight.
Hey, I think my back needs some working over.
Well, like lie the down and
miss
I'll
the
get
sun when it's stuck behind a cloud, my boy.
I thought I was a goner.
I am sure.
Well, those stinky feet, Morgan, save me.
Getting real low on meat here.
Well, we can.
Shame about Davey.
Sure. It's always a shame.
Good job, Mr. Morgan.
That it is.
Hey, it's Arthur.
What you want?
Man, you one sour son of a bitch, ain't you?
Only when I see you.
Only when I see you.
need to play again, Arthur. Let me get my revenge.
Place, is it? No. I wonder why they called it Valentine. I'm a first. Seems polar opposite of romantic.
How are you?
Lenny, all good here?
Yeah.
Herr Morgan! Herr Morgan!
Mr. Strauss?
You busy, my friend?
Why?
I'll cut you in.
Loaning. Already?
You know how it is. People is happy to borrow off someone like me, but more enthusiastic paying back to someone like you.
Of course. Who are they?
Let me see. A Chick Matthews works at Guthrie Farm. He's a hand, I believe. Mr. Roble, the small holder at Painted Sky. Runs the operations there, badly. Miss Lily Millett is a ranch maid up at Emerald Ranch.
And here was me believing Dutch's bluster about us helping folk.
It's legal work, Mr. Morgan. Debtors belong in prison. We are doing them a favor.
Aye, I'll make sure they see it in them terms.
Put the debts in the deed box and try not to kill them. It's very bad for business.
When I was in Valentine, nosing about, I think I found something interesting.
What's that, Tilly?
Well, I'm not exactly sure. Something about the doctor's office. There's something funny going on there. Saw a bunch of nasty boys going in and none of them coming out.
Thank you. Maybe I'll go take a look. Anything else?
No, just that.
Well, keep looking.
Will do.
Mr. Pearson.
Hello, Miss Pearson.
Okay there?
Ah, Mr. Morgan.
You seem chipper.
Well, where there's life, there's hope. My friend.
And?
We've been thinking about our problem all wrong. All wrong. That's all.
Meaning?
Hold your horses.
All in good time, my friend. All in good time.
Yeah.
interested in some friendly competition? I've come all the way north from Mexico to challenge a real American gunslinger. You him?
Me? A real gunslinger? Let's find out.
Okay, man. That's what I like to hear. Look, man, rules are simple, okay? Whoever shoots more of these bottles wins. Just draw your gun and aim when you're ready, all right? Shoot! Yes! Hijo de puta! How the hell did you beat me, huh? Ugh.
Better shot, I suppose.
That didn't make me happy at all. How about we raise the stakes, huh? Come on.
All right, let's do it.
Could win real... Aha, that's a good call, amigo. Okay, whoever shoots four birds out of the sky first wins. Simple enough? Stand near me, and as soon as they come out, it's anyone's shot. Be patient. Ah! There they go! Shoot! So, you can shoot, huh? Here it is, okay? Man of my word.
Appreciate it.
Sure. Better watch out next time. You'll see.
Come on, boy. Mister.
take that tone with me. I thought you said you loved me.
I do. I do. But what I get paid ain't enough for one person, let alone two. Your money's gotta be your problem now.
The only problem I got is this bleating going on in my ear.
Lily, where's our money?
What?
That loan you took. It's payday.
I'm sorry. I don't have it right now.
Well, then, I guess we got a big problem, don't we?
Cooper, give him what you've got.
I ain't giving him nothing except a lesson in damn manners!
Son of a bitch!
You've got your money. Leave me alone.
I hear about this.
I didn't steal that. It's a debt. God damn it. All right, boy.
Can the man have some peace?
Okay, boy.
Good job.
Brush that horse a bunch.
Who's there?
I'll beat you next time we play off.
Not a bad haul, boy.
Real low on meat here.
Okay, then.
Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
Thank you.
How did you get on, Herr Morgan?
Got Lily Millet's debt. Made some bad decisions in her life.
Good, very good.
My pleasure.
Well, if it's pleasure you're after, there is one other. This farmer preacher fellow I met in Valentine, Mr. Downs.
The opinionated little do-gooder? Yeah, I know the one. I certainly know the type.
Thank you, Herr Morgan.
There's no need to thank me. Like you said, it's a pleasure I'm after.
He's more slippery than he seems. I've tried being polite. Don't take any nonsense.
Nonsense? Me?
If he doesn't have the money, beat him.
Well, I usually do.
I know.
Hey, you okay, Miss Karen?
Dandy, how are you?
Well, they haven't killed me yet.
Who ain't?
The boys around here.
They act tough. They're good boys, mostly.
It's the most thing I'm scared about.
Huh? Don't be. We'll be fine. One of us now.
How you doing, Reverend?
I'm okay. I made a fool of myself again.
Drink or morphine?
Drink. Well, both, but mostly drink.
I'm sorry, Reverend.
You've always been so kind to me.
Well, you saved my life. I won't forget that.
That was long ago.
You're my family. But I have my own beliefs and family. Family is very important. Family is only there.
Lies? Who makes this crap up? Why are we having a war with the goddamn Philippines? Who cares about the Philippines? What even are the Philippines? Just a bad load of nonsense. It's enough to turn
Arthur.
Hello, Arthur. Thank you.
did good with Sean. You wouldn't have got him without you.
All we seem to do is rescue folks these days, aren't we?
Hello, Miss Grimshaw. How's your meal? Fine. I'm so glad. You know, while we were so long and hard, we couldn't have good music. Very amusing. I suggested we roasted you alive, but Mr. Pearson was keener on chopping you up and turning you into stew. Said he couldn't bear to see your face for even one moment longer than he had to. You're quite the amusing companion, aren't you? I like to think so.
Be glad Dutch didn't send you back to Blackwater with Charles and Javier.
I heard it got bloody down there.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again. If you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
Let's go, boy.
Hey, Arthur.
Hey, all good out here? Yeah!
Hey, watch it!
Who's got mouths to feed, huh?
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see.
Mrs. Linton, a caller for you.
Hello, Arthur. I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been made a widow and come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Oh, okay.
Listen, Arthur, my family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? And you want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is it?
Somewhere out near, I think. The rancher there said he'd seen him around the Cumberland Forest. I just want him back, Arthur. If you find him, bring him to me at the station.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll owe you.
You already owe me. Okay, boy. Yeah.
Take it easy. I got lumbago.
Should have thought about that earlier. You're pathetic.
You could have stepped in.
I thought you had it covered.
Just wait till you're old. I'll be at camp if you need me.
Maybe try keeping your mouth shut next time.
Good to have you on. You'd all be bored as rocks without me.
Let me take a look at you, tough guy.
Brave man.
Oh, see, you ain't tough after all.
Just leave me be.
You as dumb as you look, huh?
What's that about?
Oh,
stay
you're
away!
A pair, huh?
I'm calling the law.
I don't serve wanted men. You should leave.
Come on, move!
Crap, done with that one.
That's the man.
Yep.
And what is Chelonianism? No less than the recent rediscovery of theology.
Gentlemen!
Shall I say,
Safety.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I don't know about this nonsense. Let me speak to the boy.
Dut-dut. Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
Only when dealing with idiots. Now let me talk to the boy. You really want to do this the hard way? Goddamn lunatic.
Leave him alone. That's enough, Arthur.
Now, kid, come on. This is crap. You're better than this.
Better than what? Better than one in paradise?
Better than thinking these fools know a damn thing about paradise. Now let me take you home.
You're a sad man, Arthur. You're a real sad man.
Sure, but come home.
Not a chance! Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Just stop and let's talk about this!
This is none of your damn business! Sorry!
They're just using you! Telling you what you want to hear!
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
Come on, Jamie! Your sister's worried about you!
You pop up out of nowhere?
We gotta do this the hard way.
I don't have to answer to you.
Come on, you ain't stupid. You can see this is crazy.
You're the crazy one.
For Christ's sakes, Jamie, just hold up a minute.
I was doing just fine by myself. Arthur Morgan! Leave me alone!
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I'm gonna... I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone! warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Now calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
It's okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know, there ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son.
Yeah.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. Didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Shimonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtle.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen to him.
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Well, please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something. All right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and what was his name? Hester?
Jose. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
No doubt. But none of it is anything like the nonsense you read in the newspapers.
So, are you two getting back together?
I told you, no. Just ask me for a favor. Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
Make it quick or I might run off again.
Jamie! Jamie! Come home, please. Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur, thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur.
And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I shall.